It's Lil Murda. Man, let me talk about this dude, Lil Murda, man. He got a thing for Uncle Clifford. I got a thing for you, baby, you know. Don't want to text, but I want to get to know you. Yo, right, from the first episode, right, I'm just going to give a cover from the whole season. Man, this cat, if you go back and watch the first episode, right, he trying to walk through. Diamond's about to break his shit in. Anyway, he get in the club. And he bumps into fucking Uncle Clifford ass, right? And he tried to make it seem like an accident, but I peeped game from the jump. I'm like, either this scene was written horribly, or he bumped into Clifford on purpose, or them two knew each other, right? So he bumps into Clifford. Clifford can't hear him, so they go to another room, and they go to that classic room where all the freak shit going on at, with all like a motherfucker in the sky or something. Paradise, that's what they call that shit, the room, paradise room. And they end up talking, and they say, you know, he's trying to whip his little dingling out for Uncle Clifford. Right there, I said, oh shit, he one of them niggas. Hey, what's the bodyguard? What's the not Diamond, but the other old head cat? Oh my god, I can't remember his name for some reason. But he peeped game real quick. He peeped game real quick. Especially when Murda came knocking on that motherfucking door in the back. And first thing he said was, how the fuck that nigga know how to get back here? And he let that motherfucker in, and he looked at him, and he was like, he gave him that look like, yeah, I know you on that bullshit. You know what I'm saying? The nigga like bussy. You know what I'm saying? Like that bussy. So having Clifford creeping. Now Clifford gave this nigga out. He gave this nigga out because he knew that nigga wasn't, and he knew that nigga was on the low, right? He knew Lil Murda was on the motherfucking on the low. Now honestly, I felt like his name is like a Lil Murda. That name is like a if this is Carrera, like a double entendre, got too meanings. Like that's his rap name, but for the purpose of the show, it means something else also. It got duality, and I think the nigga might have AIDS, but we'll see in the upcoming season. I'm like, this nigga got AIDS, or he gonna catch AIDS or something. I really feel that way, you know. And I can almost guarantee you Uncle Clifford ain't gonna be the only punk he messing with. Now, where I'm from, we say punks, right? That's how we say punk, P-U-N-K. But the motherfuckers in New Orleans, I got a homegirl, she say punk. call Uncle Clifford a punk. But this shit hilarious, man. But this nigga ended up smashing Uncle Clifford in the back. I'm like, damn, boy. This nigga, and then he made the goddamn song for fucking Uncle Clifford. I usually choose that money over love. I'm like, he like, you know that shit about you, right? I'm like, damn. See, but that's how, from what I've noticed, that's how them niggas get exposed, right? That's why the punks end up exposing their asses, because the punks be on some, hey, you know, we can just do our little thing on the low, and, you know, it'll just be our little secret, it ain't gotta be nothing serious. But the niggas be like, be trying to hook the punks in. It's raining like a motherfucker, y'all. I'm driving this shit. Hold on. Yeah, so, but the niggas be like, be trying to do all extra shit for him. trying to get the punks to really like him. And I guess so they can, you know, guarantee that ass, you know. And that's what he did in classic fashion. He tried to sump Uncle Clifford in when he really should have just came over and dropped the dick off every now and then. That's all he had to do. Nobody would have known nothing. But I got a feeling Uncle Clifford gonna expose his ass eventually, because in this last episode, that motherfucker fucking flexed on motherfucking Uncle Clifford. And he lucky Clifford did, you know, didn't expose his ass right down the spot. But, you know, he come back to the room all shook up his shit, ready to fucking cry. I was just flexing. I don't know. I'm sorry. And Uncle Clifford told, she was like, motherfucker, I told your ass you weren't ready for this shit. We ain't have to do this shit. But nah, you kept pushing. You kept wanting to, you kept saying, oh, let me take you out here. Let me take you out of, knowing damn well you ain't want to do that shit. Knowing that, you know what I'm saying? You know, this is a valuable lesson. And this ain't even got nothing to do with you being gay or whatever. This is, stop saying you want to do all this shit and then you don't deliver and you renege, you know. Motherfucker, that shit come with consequences. You feel me? So, yeah, I think Clipper going to end up exposing this nigga. But if you go back to the first episode, right? When they try to come in the club with that brick to make it like they got extra money or whatever. Notice the dude who's trying to, his homeboy, the same dude that caught him coming out of the motherfucking woods with Uncle Clifford, from jacking Uncle Clifford off, that same cat, he called that dude a faggot in the first episode. He called that dude, he said, this faggot ass nigga, blah, blah, blah. And I kind of feel like them two got something going on or mess with each other on some type of level, because when the dude caught him creeping around with Clifford, I think that was his first time catching him with Clifford, because he's like, oh, I thought it was just a one-time thing. And he was like, it was. You know what I'm saying? And I guess the other dude, he keep it a G about it. He like, to me, I think him and old boy probably fucked around and dude really wanted him. But Lil Murder wasn't trying to do that. It was like, hey, man, that was just some one-time thing, experiment. You know, I don't really want nothing to do with it. But dude see that, oh, this nigga really do like Bussy. You know what I'm saying? Don't call him. So it's going to be something deep with that, too, because every now and then you catch old boy looking at him a certain way. You know what I'm saying? Hell, when they was in the studio with Mississippi, old boy was looking at him some type of way. You know what I'm saying? Giving him a little like, you know, I don't like this nigga. You know what I'm saying? Was giving him that type of vibes was coming off of old boy. So I think Lil Murray around here dicking down a few niggas. You know what I'm saying? And it's just starting to catch up with him. Just starting, you know? So, you know, it's about to be some shit with Lil Murder. You know what I'm saying? Lil Murder. I'm telling you, that nigga, I think in the end, Murder caught something. I think he got that monster. You feel me? Got that HIV. Those my predictions about Lil Murder. But anyway, yeah, those my thoughts about Lil Murder's ass. He a funny ass character to me. He funny as hell. Uncle Clifford is more hilarious. I'm gonna do a video about Uncle Clifford too. Uncle Clifford is like one of my favorite characters. Honestly, Diamond is my favorite character, even though he don't have a big role like that. But I can relate to Diamond a lot. But yeah, Clifford, I mean, Murder, Clifford's one of my favorite characters. But anyway, that's my thoughts on Lil Murder, and I'll holler at y'all.